Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Necessary. Today I'm going to talk to you about the agencies in Jamaica for the J1 program. But before I get into all that, like how you're here and you're listening to me, please subscribe to my channel. You know, if it's worth watching, why not subscribe, right? And you know, give this video a thumbs up if you like it. If you don't like it, give it the thumbs down, because I want to know what you guys like from what you guys don't like. And if you have any questions on anything, my life, anything that's related to this channel, anything that's related to me, you can ask me. It doesn't have to be about J1, even though the last few videos is on J1. The reason why I'm, you know, focusing on J1 programs is the fact that that's what's going on now. The registration is going on. Some agencies are already closed off, so you know, I'm just trying to be current with you guys so you guys can, you know, follow up and get information on stuff that, you know, many of you didn't know. So yeah, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you don't, give it a thumbs down. Hit the notification bell so when I release a new video, you will be the first to know. And yeah, let's get talking. As I told you, today I'm going to talk about the different agencies in Jamaica, and I'm going to list all the agencies that I talk about in the description below. And if you have any questions or you have any additional information for anyone else to see, you know, you can, you know, comment down below and I'll definitely get back to you. And you know, other person may see and you may enlighten someone, so just tell us what you know in the comments down below. All right so this program, as you all know, is an international cultural exchange program for students, and you have to be a full-time student and you have to do like a minimum of 12 credits per semester, and you have to have some money, right? Because to go on a program, you have to definitely pay. So these programs are ranging between $1,100 to like $1,600, depending on which agency you choose. The most expensive one I know is like Steep Subsection Geovision, and I'll get to that soon. But yeah, let me talk about some of the agency. So the first agency is IRSS, and I think the IRSS is stand for International Recruiting Staffing Solution, something like that. And for that program, I know it's legit because I know a person that went on that with that agency. And for all the agencies that I'm going to talk about, I'm going to, you know, they're all legit, and I have to really tell you guys this because there's a lot of agency out there that's, you know, robbing the students, you know, pretending to be a company which they're not, and people putting their trust in them and, you know, giving their money, and you know, at the end of the day you heard that it was a scam, because the scam of them, they IRSS is a next agency, is trustworthy, you can use it. You know, I know many person that use IRSS, and the only thing is, guys, they're closed for now. But even though they said that they're closed, you can probably try a look and go to the office, because many person actually sign up and then they actually follow, so then that space will become available, so you guys can go to IRSS and try a look. But other than that, they're closed for the season, so that will be next year again. And that program allow people to go more than 3 times. You know, once you're in university and you're doing the 12 credits, you can go more than 3 times on that program. And they have a agency in St. Anne's, or those person in St. Anne's or the surrounding area, you can find an agency in St. Anne's. They also have one in Crossroad, so all the Kingstonians can go to that location and yeah, go and sign up. But the next one is EJAM. So EJAM, I know person that goes on EJAM. I know person that go with EJAM, and I know it's legit, but for me personally, I don't really like it. And it's not because I've been there, I've heard negative news about them. It's because they don't have a physical location, like where you actually go and sign up and do all your registration process. They do everything online, so you have to register online, you have to upload photos, IDs, school information, status letter and transcript and all of those stuff. You have to upload those online, and when you make payments, you have to take a photocopy of the receipt and upload it online. And for me personally, I'm a very technical person. I like to ask questions, and I just want to see the person so I can ask them as much question as I want, because I'm spending so much money, and I don't think like I should just be blindfolded and give someone my money just like that. I know you can call them and you can get the information that you want, but as I said, for me, I like to see the person in person. So, but it's a good company, but that's my 2 cents on EJAM. So you can check those guys out if you don't have any time, or you live like far, like probably Montego Bay, St. Elizabeth, or whatever, you can check them out online. The next company is Job Seekers. I have a friend that actually went with Job Seekers, so I know it's legit. They not only do international placement, they do local placement. Like all the jobs you see on Classified is actually on Job Seekers. So you can, if you don't want to go abroad, you can go on their website and, you know, send in your resume and look for a local job. So yeah, that's it for Job Seekers. Global Insight. Now, Global Insight is the company that I've been going with for the last 3 years. They're very good, and they are very informative. Like, they send you a lot of information in your email, and all you need to do is read and, you know, complete everything and then bring it into the office. But oftentimes, we all know that Jamaicans don't love to read, and I am guilty of this. Like, everything will be stated in the email, and then you'll have like a lot of person coming into the office and, you know, asking the same questions that was actually listed into the email, and, you know, made the line so long for us who is actually reading the email, bringing all of the documents one time. But no, we have to wait on them to ask the same question that they actually put in the email. So guys, if you're going with Global Insight, please to read all the information. It will make life so easy. But yeah, I like Global Insight, and my last experience was not so good, like from the previous 2 experience. The reason for this is because I think the amount of person that's actually looking for J1 placement is increasing, and they saw the need to open up their arms and take everyone. And because of that reason, it was so stressing on us who was there from a very long time. And I don't think like they were actually prepared for the amount of work, and I don't think they were actually, you know, as I said, I don't think they were prepared for the amount of work. But the long and short of it, it actually went through. Job placement was a bit slow, but at the end of the day, everything was good. We just need a little bit more patience, I guess. So Global is a very good one. That's the one I've been with 3 times. So if I've been there 3 times, you know it's good, despite the little complaints that I have. So you guys can go and check out Global. It's in New Kingston. They have international sponsors come and talk about the different jobs and what they expect of us, and tell us the laws and rules and regulations. They also have employers from US come to talk to us and tell us about the job and what is required of us. And they, if they don't come in person, they do virtual stuff. And yeah, so you know, they're well organized. Yeah, anyway, the last one that I'm going to talk to you about is Steep. And the reason why I'm talking to you about this one is because I've transferred from Global to Steep. And the reason for this is because Global has actually put a cap on the amount of time you can go with them and go to the US. They said that we cannot go more than 3 times, and I told you I actually went with them 3 times already. So yeah, my relationship with Global is finished. So I had to go and look for an agency that can accommodate me, and there Steep was. So Steep now is on Oxford Terrace, and it actually on one of my campus. And what I can tell you that's very good about Steep, the fact that they allow you to go more than 3 times, and the fact that their age limit is a bit more than the other rest. Because you can be going to, cause you know, in Jamaica, we have person that's 80, 70, 50, 80. We have a lot of old person in school, you know, doing their degree because they want a better pay. So yeah, so Steve actually cater for these persons. So if you're like 40-year-old, 30-year-old, and you want to go on a work and travel program, then Steep welcomes you. And I think the reason why they are allowed to do this is because they actually have a different sponsor than the others, because most of these most of the other agencies use CIEE or Spirit in Track, but Steep have agency that's a sponsor that's actually new to me, and that's GeoVision. So you guys can go and look that out. So yeah, and I'll tell you guys my experience as the months go on and you know the process continues. Alright, so guys, there's going to be a job fair soon, so I'll vlog, well, try to vlog, because I don't really like to vlog in public. For one, it's not safe, and two, just look, everyone looking at you like you're weird. You know, this girl talking to her phone, like, who does that? Yeah, so it's gonna be a bit weird, but I'll try, and I'll give you guys updates on that. So yes guys, that's it for now. You know, thank you guys for watching, thank you guys for subscribing, and if you have not subscribed, you know, hit the subscription button, then you hit the notification button so that you can be the first to know when I release a new video. And you know, share this. Maybe you have some, you know, high school students that's going to college next year and would like, you know, to know how they're gonna pay their school fee and if they should resort to student loan, which I definitely don't agree with. You know, send them over to my channel, you know, because this video is gonna be relevant to them next year and the year after and the year after and the year after. Because guess what? This is an ongoing program. Even though Trump wanted to discontinue the program, but I don't think he could do that because, for one, there's a lot of work to do in the United States of America, especially when it comes down to summer. So they need international people to come and work. Yeah, so I don't think he can do that. Anyhow, thank you guys for tuning in. Bye.